asking for God. God has called us to be the children. How do we take this form to invite Holy Spirit into our life? And we that God Almighty to speak unto us today from Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. How do I help you to take this form? Jesus' name. I want to appreciate very much, Lord, for your word has gone We thank you, Lord, because you have forced us to hear you. Father, we bless your name today. It is something in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, we have invited you. I will ask you, Lord, my God, that you take control of our lives in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ, your Father, your Savior, we have called upon you also. Lord, we pray that you be, O Lord, in our life, all the days of our life in the name of Jesus. Our Heavenly Father, God Almighty, we thank you, Lord, because you are so good unto us. You are so wonderful, you are so marvelous. Father, we bless you, Lord, then in the name of Jesus. God, as we continue your word today, Father, we pray that you pass your word with your power in the name of Jesus. God, we pray that as you reassure us, Father, we ask that you cause our heart to be at rest with you in the name of Jesus. God, our mind will not be wondering about in the name of Jesus. God, my God, I pray that every plan of religion to take your word for children will cancel them in the name of Jesus. God, we pray every spirit of enemy that wants to cheat your children, God, will find them in the name of Jesus. Our prayer is to be not take charge of this environment in the name of Jesus. We charge this environment with the power of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. And Jesus, Lord, in the name of Jesus. As we look unto you, Father, we pray that you can also give me in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Praise the Lord. Thank you very much, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I also need this time to welcome every one of us. We have come to the Lord Almighty, and I know the Lord Almighty that has brought you here, He has a word for you, and His mind is to keep us. His mind is to help us, and today He will show them us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord! And see, from the beginning of this program, I was wondering, because today's medical Sunday, and when I took like a songs that have been sung by the choir. That's what one phrase, I mean, the one that talks about the whole world of his hand. Praise the Lord. The word of assurance of the Lord Almighty. And when I look at the other songs that we did, also this is something that was waiting on the Holy Spirit. And basically, the topic of this word of God, of encouragement to us today, that the Lord is bringing to us is the fact that we need to wait on the Lord. Praise the Lord. The topic for me is to wait on the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Waiting on God. A child of God must wait on the Lord. And I tell you that every one of us, no matter what you are passing through, whether you are hanging it well or not, God is telling us today, the word of God to every one of us today, is that we should wait on Him. The grace to wait on Him is not be granted to us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. I want to tell us, I want to talk about my question, and you are saying that to wait, what do you mean by to wait? To wait means to stay in place in expectation of something. To stay in place in expectation of something. And I want to remain in readiness or in expectation. To remain in readiness or in expectation. I'm calling the problem to look forward expectantly. When you ask for something, then you look forward to receiving it. And then it says to be ready and available. The Lord will make us available in the day of salvation in Jesus' name. Anyone that is told to wait on God always receives the promise of God. Especially when you wait according to His plan for your life. Waiting on the Lord means to rely on God Almighty. When you just wait, it's not that you just pray and No. You rely on God and you put God first in your life, you make God first in every aspect of your life. It's to look to God in expectation for His promises. And I tell you that God If the business of African prayer, and we offer us to them that more Jesus prayer. So one of the most important positions of the word of the Lord from the Bible is the call for us to wait. So many things God tells us to wait. Wait. And this one is our God. I tell you that most people don't like it. In fact, in the world, you don't want, nobody wants to wait. And that's the problem we have. Waiting is something that has become a big problem in the nation. Praise the Lord. If you take the example of our contemporary world, most of the technology that are people use is just to reduce time. It's just time of taking something, especially all the inventions. When you make it, maybe, when you make an inflection, and then it's taking maybe 1 hour, you want to see how to be able to reduce the time and continuously. And that is the problem we have. This is also entering the church. I pray the Lord will grant us the grace to wait upon him in Jesus' name. Examples of our society today that to show the patience of man. When you go to the military station, as you see people queuing up, you see systems that cannot wait. They will come, they will just stop, they will not wait and then have their way. Praise the Lord. Inventions that are revealed also are part of the science of man to cause short time so that they will not be waiting. That's why they invented the microwave. You can quickly make food and just get out of the house. And then the thing is the simple conversation. Waiting is that because if you want to hear quickly from one another, so the only thing is to be the right letter from one place to the other and then begin to wait once you get that letter. But nowadays, we find that man has invented in the process of cutting short time for businesses, they made phones that you can communicate even at the same time you speak and get supply. Praise the Lord. And so also, I will tell you that in doing this, the quality of things have become reduced. Praise the Lord. I know that there was a time when we were making pictures, we found that to get the picture out of the camera, they were going to take the picture, take it down through, and then you wait for the process, and then you now get it out. And then, the other thing we invent on that one, that makes it better, but say, wait and get. This is about we click it, and the thing comes out. But I want to tell you that, even from our own experience, which one do you think is better? Is it the one that takes precedence to produce, or the one that you take it and wait and get? I tell you that, wait and get pictures are not as quality as those that are processed, that go through the processes before they come out. So also is the life of the church of God. Praise the Lord. And the mind of God has always been for us to wait upon him. And I told you that waiting upon God means to rely on him, to depend on him, and to make him the focus of our life. And the father will say that, if you go back to the Bible, let's look at Genesis chapter 1. Praise the Lord. When God made Adam and made all the other things, in God's very power was that man, it is not good for man to be alone. And that is where God started this area of waiting upon him. And he took Adam to sleep. And while sleeping, he took a rib out of his bones and caused him to have a deep sleep. In that process of sleep, what he's doing is waiting on God. He's depending on God. And in the process of time, we knew that Eve was produced from Adam. Praise the Lord. But we found that this took some time for Eve to get out. And I pray the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. How was we looking to be like the time? 25:3-5. The Bible says, those who wait on him shall not be ashamed. How do you think they will be ashamed? Yes, let not that wait on him be ashamed. Let them be ashamed which transgress without cause. But him, show me thy will, O Lord, this may the path. Let me keep me in thy truth, and teach me, for thou art the goal of my salvation. On this do I win all the day. God will cause us to wait for him at all times in Jesus' name. And with it, there are things that we find within that are very necessary for us. And because God says that this one for us to wait on, that's why he gave us that instruction that we should wait. Let us look at some essential things that are found in waiting on God. Number one is that waiting necessitates passage to time. There is a need for time, and that time is your process to make sure that we are ready for the blessings which God has packaged for us. Praise the Lord. In the New Testament also, we saw Jesus Christ when he was ascended into heaven. He gave a charge to his disciples. As we look at Acts chapter 1, verse 4. Let's look at Acts chapter 1, verse 4. It says, "I have been assembled together with them, commanding them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which sent him, they have heard of me." Praise the Lord. And in Acts chapter 2, verse 4, let's look at this. After waiting on God and on Jesus Christ, we saw that God gave him the promise that he should wait for him. He should wait until he is able to enter God. And in Acts chapter 2, verse 1 to 4, it says, "And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one accord in one place. And suddenly, there came the sound of them and of the rushing mighty wind, and filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them glowing tongues like as of fire, and sat upon each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues, and the Spirit gave them utterance." Praise the Lord. So there was a lapse of time. When you do that, you will not have to tell you anything, but you will wait until you have received his power. And that commandment has to be read. And wait for the day in the faith promise. As long as God has a promise of God, we shall see the promise in Jesus' name. It's a promise that God has given. So the time of waiting is all from the time of asking for prayer and the time of asking for receiving. That time is long to be short, but God has decided that. Praise the Lord. The first thing is confident expectation. You are confident that you have been promised. You know, before you can expect something from somebody, you must have the assurance that yes, this person is able to give it to you. And we have the God that is powerful. As you are studying the Bible today, it is powerful God, it is older, it is the God that holds all power. And since we have to have power, we should be in confidence, in expectation that we receive from him whatever we ask. In Psalm 119, verse 5, I want to say, there's a verse 6, Psalm 119, verse 5 to 8. Psalm 119, verse 5 to 8. Praise the Lord. "Since for my ways, for the Lord, my soul doth wait, and in his words I hope. My soul waited for the Lord, more than day and watch for the morning. I say more than day that was for the mountain. Let's move the Lord. And God is saying, let us hear, wait, and go on the Lord. For we know that is mercy, and we hear the plenty of redemption. And shall lead Israel from all iniquities." Some of you want to say that we want children. Every other home, we need to be equal to what I say. That place was saying that we are in the world of sin. God, we are in order to come that we never give us, we never give us, we never forsake us. We need to go on to God in order to come to God as we come across. And God will like to oppose us in the mighty name of Jesus. We have so many examples in the Bible of men that held on to God, even in the same situation that this and this form of God was called never failed. Because that can be the problem and you never fail. And the Lord will not fail your life in the mind of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Now, which is also, as I said, this is a different of life, it's a different of life, and then also, this is also a confident expression in drugs. It's also one of the things that waiting involves both negatives and positives. That means, why do we think that some things we do that are not supposed to be done, those are the negatives. And there are some that God has told us to do. And I want us to look at the Word of God to confirm that. I want us to look at the book of Psalm 37, 37 to 9. Let's look at some of the things that we need to do and some of the things that we don't need to do. The ones we need to do are the positive side of the world, and then ones that we don't need are the negative ones. It says, let the result as a result of going across the world, the Bible tells us we should let the result and wait patiently for him. Set not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way, because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass. See from anger, we are not to be happy and forsake wrath. Set not thyself in any wise to do evil. We are not to commit evil or error in the process of preaching of God. For evil doers shall be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. Praise the Lord! Praise the Lord! Let us see those coming next week. You know, when you are put God in charge of something, then you don't need to fret yourself. You don't need to, you don't allow you to be taken away, you don't allow emotions to run out and begin to maybe get angry, begin to cause, begin to backfire. No, when you put your trust in God, then leave it to God to solve. He is the one that can solve it and will show it for us in the name of Jesus. In the former part of that Psalm 7, let's take it again. That's one of six. So Psalm 7:1-6, it says, "Set not thyself because of evil doers. Never be thou envious against the worker of iniquity. For he shall soon be cut off, cut down like the grass, and withered as the green herb. Trust in the Lord and do good, so shalt thou dwell in the land. And verily, thou shalt be fed." Praise the Lord. It says, "Delight also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thy heart." How do we to delight? That means you stick to the Word of God, you commit yourself to the service of God. It's not the time for you to fall back or begin to withdraw from God. In fact, waiting brings us closer to God. It says, "Commit thy way unto the Lord, trust also in him, and he shall bring it to pass." Praise the Lord. "And shall bring forth thy righteousness as the light, and thy judgment as the noonday." Praise the Lord. This is the word of encouragement for every one of us. And as children of God, I tell you that there is no one that can escape it. That is, waiting on God is for everybody. In fact, we are all called to the life of waiting on God. And that is that depending on God, a life of making our life able to please God. That is our motion. And the God of God will keep us to do that in the name of Jesus. In the book of Lamentations, chapter 3, waiting involves seeking God. It's a type of one to seek the Lord. Lamentations, chapter 3, verse 25. It says, "The Lord will move of the dead that wait for him, to the soul that is kept." Therefore, it is good that the man goes home and quietly wait for the salvation of God. Praise the Lord. It is good to go to God and wait for the salvation of the Lord. The Lord will keep us watching and speaking him at all times in the mighty name of Jesus. We need to take time to study the Word of God. It is time for us to get closer to God. It is time for us to seek answers and to claim God's promises. We have a Bible with you. When you open your Bible, you begin to read, and God begins to encourage you. Even in your process, the Lord is the one that can give you the heart that can make you to be a rest assured. Seek the Lord in talking His word. Seek the Lord in taking His promises. And mostly, seek the Lord in prayer. Pray about issues that have been troubling you, and also pray for wisdom. pray for his family. When you study the Holy Ghost with all your mind, you know, our heart is to commit our body to be close to God, but we are to live it at that level. Make sure that you raise yourself on him. Also to pray unto God, ask for wisdom and discernment. Take time to meditate on who God is. We have a God that is all powerful, a God that has done great things for men of God, that we told you this in the Bible, that some of the things that we are told that are examples are for our examples to see how great the Lord has done. Open to the book of Acts, look at what God is through David, what he did through Samson, what he did through all those men of God, and begin to see that God is just history compared to the one that this other man went in, like Job, like Hannah. I pray the Lord will grant us the grace even to meditate on his word and his much. So we have to take time to meditate on who God is and that what he wants to do with us. First of all, the reason why you have to wait is because God wants to do something special in life. And it is you who is going to wait. If you refuse to wait, then that thing is not speak. You know, you're not doing it. I mean, if you're doing that person, God will grant us the patience to wait on him and our life in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. You see, we have some benefits. Before I say, I will take some of the men of God that waited on God. Somebody else will look at some of the benefits that we can derive from waiting on God. As we look at the benefits of waiting, let's look at Isaiah chapter 40. Isaiah chapter 40. I want to take it from verse 29. Isaiah 40, 29. Okay, it says, he gives power to the faint, and to them that have no mind, he increases strength. Even the youth is affected and the weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they, that is you and I, they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. One of the benefits is that when you wait upon God, no matter the level of your life, your life will be renewed. Your strength will be renewed again. So one of the benefits you can see there is that they shall renew their strength. That's one. Secondly, they shall not fall off wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. And you shall walk and not faint. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know, it has been established basically that there are three kinds of flying. Bird flying in three different ways. You see, there are three levels of flying in bed. One method is by flapping. Flapping is just to move. That is one method. Then, this method is the most laborious one. That means it takes strength, it takes time, it takes most energy. So the second one is gliding. Gliding means the best flies against those who are high and then it drops and begins to glide. You know, you have to make them to drop again, go up and glide down. But when you look at that person, that people, let's say that you say, they shall mount up with wings as eagles. Eagles swallow. The third method is swallowing. Swallowing is that with little effort, by the treatment of the wings of the eagle, it's able to know the wings. You know, the adult is the wings to impact the grip with the air and still make it to keep going and on. So, what's happening now? It can go a little bit and going on and on and on. Praise the Lord. What does that mean? It's been nice. From the knowledge that God has given you. And that's why the little effort is able to go higher and higher. And that's why God is using people as an example of those that wait for him. That he won't come to me. And if you start with this effort, God will begin to do special things in your life. And especially in the name of Jesus.